friends, it's me, Odo, and I'm back with my Let's Play for Europa Universalis 4, and we are again Oda, or Japan, as you can see, and we are just, waiting a bit. Lansang would also accept our alliance. How many alliances do we have? We have 4 out of 6 relationship slots. Let's do this like that. They wouldn't. Yeah, no. We are their rivals, so yeah. They would not. This was dumb. Can we lose 25 prestige? Really? Yeah. Except, why not? I mean, we don't have to do anything about it, do we? So, whom are we at war with? Really? Thai Viet? Is this everyone? Therefore, you fetched me into the war? You couldn't do that by yourself? I mean, ugh. Stupid. If Ming would go to war with someone. I really don't want to fight Ming over Tondo, over Manila and this region, because this is kind of boring to do this. But on the other hand, if I don't do the war on my terms, then they'll come to do war on their terms, and probably that's also not the best idea. Take on foreign debt and influence nation, yeah. Whatever. Issue embargo, revoke embargo, some give subsidies. claims on someone else, but I have a lot of claims on Tondo, and also I have the claims on Heixi. I don't need claims on Muriati as they are my tributaries, although I have even claims on them. I can't get some on Oirat or Mongolia because we are blocked by our vassal and tributary. We could try to vassalize someone else. To do this, how about you? How about you show me who is near vassalization, diplo-vassalization, Sulu? But I really don't think. Interesting. How about tributary status? Why don't I see if I can make a tributary out of someone? I can't make you into tributary because you are already a tributary. And the vassalization is not possible because we own a core of you. Yeah. And even without the core, it would be hard to get you to accept that. We're just not central enough to do anything. Nice, but I believe succumb is still oh no, we can't because we are building a temple there. So how about this? anymore. We don't want to develop this region. Do we have a religious edict on? Yeah. There it is. But these two are not part of the country. They are just transformed to. Let's stop this. Let's do these. These are probably somewhere here around Gangneung, Wonju. Yeah. So let's enforce religious unity here. Yay! Even faster. So how many ships do we have? And ah yeah. Now I wanted to take this tech and this tech. We can now build banner infantry, whatever this is. But we can do it. Ah, I see. It's probably this here. Yay, better infantry. So we probably should fight Ming because we are ahead of Ming now. 2 military tanks. But I mean, they are ahead of us. We have 262 troops while we have 65,000 troops. I mean, they have no manpower. This is really strange, and they have 68 mercenaries. This must be really, really terribly expensive. I mean, money do they have? Province, province, state, territory, religion, score for time, score for ages, score of comparison, governments, country, yeah, there they are. And let's do by income. We have the second highest income here. Wow, that's great. We have a high stability, but they also, I mean, they have double my income. They have no inflation. And they have double my development. They have a teeny weeny bit more manpower, maximum manpower than me, but we have more manpower at the time, so yeah. Ten, 12, and 12, and they are at 11, 11, 10. 21 ideas and we have 20. Yeah. What can you do? But we should get... we should get the next idea, which is the last in this idea group, soon. This will give us even more money, and it will give us more manpower. So when will hike cease? Truce expire in 1551. Yeah, that's not very soon. Is there another war we want to start? I mean, with Korea, obviously, but they're even later. The truce is even later up than the hike C one. So we'll just wait. Probably, yes. Because I really don't want to fight Ming. They seem so, what's it called? Einschüchternd. Yeah, we can get a few more ships. Let's do this. Like you. Ships and you get also another ship, another few ships. Prospering times. Yo, we get admin, military or diplomacy. Yeah, we'll take the admin, of course. Those underhanded rogues in Ming have the goal to claim Sakam as their own, okay. How dare they do this? Yay, competitive merchants. So our other ideas are through. We've got expansion ideas through. New policies available. Pioneer policy and commercial embassies. Okay, let's see. What do we have? We have an admin and a diplomacy. Yeah, that's good. We don't have to pay for that then. But what do they do? Automatically discover adjacent whenever a colony is built. Yeah, why not? And global trade power, diplomatic reputation up. Yeah, that's also good. That's fine. So we'll probably colonize next Stanovoy, because it will give me some access to this country's. So let's see, we have really nice land now. Japan is nearly fully prosperous. Only these pits where Ming got up to the island is a bit destroyed. here we are getting prosperity. Would be great to destroy the prosperity for them. Yeah, why not? Let's see. Oh, we could get some money. Oh. In 11 days we can get this. We lose 20 loyalty, and with this we lose 10 loyalty. Yeah. But we get really a lot of money for a new manufactory. Yeah, but it's only diplomatic support, not administrative. I don't know if this is really... How about this war going on? Yeah, and another of my advisors died. Is there an advisor half price? A military advisor? No. They are all full price. Bushi, do you have a... Just have a general. How about the minister? Nearly inflation. population reduction is also good. I really don't want to pay full price level 3. I mean, they are really expensive. Let's take him, why not? I mean, he's better than nothing. Do we have an inflation reduction guy? Yeah. There is one. But he's just a level 1. And now we have a level 3 half price or quarter price. Yeah, anyway. We will stop for today. I hope you enjoyed our campaign. And I hope you will watch soon again. Until then, see you. Bye.